The premise of Zombieland Saga is as straightforward as it can be. What if idols, but also zombies? To keep it short, Zombieland Saga follows a group of zombie girls that perform music shows with the help of their insanely reliably unreliable manager, who somehow accomplishes extremely difficult tasks while failing at simple ones. Everything is part of the manager's master plan, who wants to mold this undead troupe into professional idols who can save the prefecture of Saga through the power of music. Zombieland Saga had a not great but fantastic start that surprised anyone who went into it blind. It flipped everyone's expectations with a twist called Drakkun, and it kept the bar high with its following performances, which are arguably the best out of the entire anime, and I'm obviously talking about the metal performance and the rap battle between Sakura and Saki. Sakura being both the protagonist of the anime and the protagonist of the Drakkun twist. She is enthusiastic, clumsy enough to get bodied by a truck before the opening credits kick in, and a passionate girl who dreams of becoming an idol. As you may think, she doesn't survive and is therefore resurrected a decade later as a zombie alongside other six girls from six different generations to form a legendary Saga idol group named Franchushu. The other girls are Mizuno Ai, an actual idol and Sakura's contemporary, although she doesn't recognize Ai because of her memory loss. Kono Junko, the other actual idol, but she's part of the early idol boom of the 80s. The other four members weren't exactly idols in their time alive, but they're the members who have the most defined personalities. We have Yugiri, a legendary Oiran, which means woman of pleasure, or in other words, an upper-class prostitute, who came from the Meiji era. Hoshikawa Lily, a sickeningly sweet child, actress, actor, from a very recent period. Nikaido Saki, aka Real Best Girl, is a delinquent biker boss who feels like she ruled the underground in the late 90s. And did I mention she's the best girl? And last but not least, the legendary Yamada Tae, who is a legend. And she's also the one that I kind of like the least. I know, right? I understand the appeal behind her, but I'm simply not a fan. My preferences kind of line up like this: Saki, Ai, Sakura, Yugiri, Junko, Lily, and Tae. It may not be the most popular opinion, but the point I'm trying to make, okay, maybe there's no point here, but I'm making one right now, there's a variety of girls to choose from. They all have their very distinct personalities, maybe with the exception of Ai and Junko, who do feel a little too similar for the most part, and traits which makes it easy to relate to at least one of them, one way or another, as their appeal is broad. But I suppose that's how an idol anime should be. I haven't watched one entirely, so please bear with me. Now, the fact that we have an actual gang member, Saki, and an actual prostitute, Yugiri, from very distinct eras, is so much better than simply having some characters who resemble that archetype. It feels much more genuine because they act naturally according to their specific era, which makes their actions more believable. However, other than that, there isn't really anything else that separates the characters in Zombieland Saga from regular idol archetypes, except Tae, who is a legend. Which leads me to address the elephant in the room. I wouldn't have kept watching the show if it wasn't for the glorious and truly hilarious performance of Mamoru Miyano as the manager Tatsumi Kotaro, who is, without a doubt, the real MVP of the show. This guy represents the entire comedy in the show, for me at least. Every time he's on the screen, he does or says something hilarious which makes me love him even more. His comedic timing, frequent wild shifts in his vocal register, and commitment to humming up each and every line infuses his scenes with a magical manic energy. It just sounds like he's having a blast. And I dare say that if the performance of the manager was average or just good-ish, or if he wasn't voiced by Mamoru or someone else as good as him, then I genuinely think the anime would have been significantly less popular and definitely not as funny as it is with Mamoru Miyano. I would have probably dropped Zombieland Saga a long time ago, because let's be honest, the manager is the life of the anime, quite literally. There is this promotional video about the show back from August, which features Mamoru Miyano as the manager, Tatsumi Kotaro, and because Zombieland Saga is an original work, I'm kind of starting to think that Kotaro may have been designed after Mamoru, because he is just perfect for the role. But this is just an assumption and I might be wrong. Speaking of assumptions, some people assume that Zombieland Saga is a parody of idol shows, and I wouldn't quite call it a parody. I don't think it tries to ridicule the idol genre, as some people say, or that those terrible CGI scenes are part of the ridicule. I think that those CGI scenes are genuine and what the creators thought to be good. Now I know that it's just 2 minutes of the girl dancing, so you may be thinking, what's the big deal? There is no big deal here. It's not that I have a big problem with the CGI used in performances. It's not good, but it's tolerable. The thing is, the performances in the first 2 episodes were great. They were part of those episodes' highlight, they were something that you would look forward to in an episode. While the others were just okay, and I think a lot of people felt that. The first 2 episodes had a metal performance and a rap battle, which were unexpected and fantastic on top of that. But after that, they kind of turned into your regular idol performances, which isn't bad, but I'd rather look forward to a great performance in every episode than the CGI ones, that I just have to tolerate. But leaving the CGI aside, the show is fundamentally about cute girls working hard and forging friendships, so it engages with many of those idol tropes. The anime has a different approach to the idol genre. It concentrates on the creation of an idol group, zombie idol group, and their past struggles, but does it in a comedic way and relies on comedy as its main genre, which I don't think any idol anime has ever done before. I mean, comedy is part of them, but never the main focus. However, at the core, it's still about the formation of an idol group, their performances, and how they try to make a name for themselves to save something, in this case, Saga. At some point, I had a feeling that the anime was going to turn into a regular idol show, which was a huge step down for me at the moment, and made me put it on hold for a few weeks. And to be honest, if I didn't take a break from it and kept watching, I would have probably just drop it and be done with it, because there was Mamoru with his jokes and nothing else that would differ from the idol formula. Only later on, when each character had its own arc, I started to regain my interest in the anime, because it again deviated from the standard idol formula and explored some fresh, distinct and unusual stories for some of the characters. The third and fourth episodes were, in my opinion, the weak point of the show, but after that it raised the bar again and it was great. Now, I wouldn't call it an idol anime either, but rather a subversion of the idol genre. Now, does this mean that you should watch other idol anime? Is this your gateway to your idol shows? Hell no! If you think that sending a zombie idol group to perform at a death metal venue when only one of them is even sentient, or giving a pep talk to a room full of mindless zombies is something you'll find in any other idol anime, come on, you can't even think of that. I don't think that Zombieland Saga is or should be a gateway to idol anime. Remove the comedy and Tatsumi Kotaro and the distinct personalities, and there you have your regular idol anime. Zombieland Saga is a subversion of the idol genre, and it should stay that way. But what do you think? Did Zombieland Saga made you watch some idol anime? Am I wrong not categorizing it as an idol show? Let me know what do you think. And as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you all next time.